गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, आई एम मनाली एंड माय टुडेज टॉपिक इज डेटा माइनिंग. सो हियर आर द कंटेंट्स ऑफ माय टॉपिक. आई विल फर्स्टली गिव द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द टॉपिक फॉलोड बाय द ब्रीफ ऑन सिस्टम. नेक्स्ट इज लिटरेचर सर्वे फॉलोड बाय कंक्लूजन एंड एट लास्ट आई विल गिव द रेफरेंसेज ऑफ माई टॉपिक. सो हियर इज द इंट्रोडक्शन. आई हैव चोजन दिस टॉपिक बिकॉज देर इज अ वास्ट ग्रोथ ऑफ डेटा माइनिंग टेक्नोलॉजीज. As you all know, without data, there is no use of any IT companies or industries. Data should be arranged in a precise manner, and there should be only specific data which we need. Data mining process is continued from many ages. Early techniques were Bayes' theorem and regression. The generation and growing power of computer science have boosted data collection, storage, manipulation, as data sets have broadened size and complexity levels. Explicitly hands-on investigation have progressively been improved with indirect. Here are the examples of data mining processes includes network neurals, clustering, genetic algorithms, decision trees, etc. So here is the brief on data mining. So what does data mining exactly means? I'll explain you with a small example. Suppose there is a multinational company. If a person wants a record or information about a person which is an IT head of that company, that person can use any of the data mining techniques and save his time. So I'll give with the definition. Data mining is defined as process which is used to extract usable data from a larger set of raw data. It implies analysis data analysis patterns in large batches of data using one or more softwares. So there are lots of applications of data mining. In sciences and researches, data mining is the process of finding anomalies, patterns, and correlationship between large data sets to predict the outcomes. So what does data mining exactly does? Data mining automatically creates patterns. It gives prediction based on likely outcomes. It also does creation of object-oriented information. It mainly focuses on large data sets and databases for analysis. Also, it does clustering based on finding and visually documented group of facts not previously known. So here is the literature survey of my topic. I'll explain the concept of data mining by again taking an example. If there is a scenario of a supermarket, if a data mining analysis observed that people who buy pens tends to buy pencils too, then for better business results, the seller can place pencils and pens together. It is usually used by business analysis organizations and financial analysts, but it is increasingly used in sciences to extract information. So here are the data mining strategies which can be grouped as follows. First is classification, followed by estimation, next is prediction, and last is clustering. So classification, I'll again take an example. Whether a customer has to be a trustworthy customer or a defaulter in credit card transaction, it is based on the classification part. In classification, the output is categorical. Next is estimation. Like in classification, the purpose of estimation model is to determine a value for an unknown output attribute. However, unlike classification, the output for an estimation problem are numeric rather than categorical. Here is an example. Estimate the salary of an individual who owns a sports car. In estimation, we don't have any huge data sets. We only have to estimate by the current situation. Next is prediction. Prediction, it is not easy to differentiate prediction from classification or estimation. The only difference between prediction and classification is that the predictive model predicts a future outcome. The example of it would be, what will be the price of Samsung latest phone in next month depending on its popularity and its feature? So, depending on the past values, we can predict the price of the phone. The final part is clustering. So, what does clustering means? Grouping of same sets or objects based on their similarity is known as clustering. The example of it would be, the people who buy Xiaomi phone would be clustered into the set of the people who love brand Xiaomi. And the people who bought Samsung phone would be clustered into the set of people who love Samsung brand. The conclusion would be, data mining techniques are widely used in today's world and will be used in future too. This will reduce the complexity when there is huge amount of data. Also, it will take our less time. Here are the references. Thank you for patient listening.